Hello friends, in this session we'll discuss about asynchronous processing using message queues in system design or distributed systems. First of all, let's understand what is synchronous and asynchronous processing. What is synchronous processing? In simple words, you went to a shop, ordered your items, and you waited there till you get your ordered items from the shop and return back only after you got your items. So here, let's say entire time to get things from the shop is around 10 minutes. Let's apply the same logic on the application too. You made a call on this application and you will be waiting until you get desired response back. Here, the application take a few milliseconds or few seconds or few minutes to respond back, but you will wait until you get response. This is called synchronous call. No matter what the response time is, you want to get your task done and you want to get the acknowledgement then and there only. Now, let's say your application is taking 10 seconds to process your request. In order to process your request, first it is validating your input, storing them into database, registering a request with order processing service. Order processing service is another microservice that your application is internally talking to. On successful confirmation from order processing system or service, your application issues acknowledgement back to you. So this is taking total of 10 seconds in order to process your request. Now there are thousands of such requests coming at the same time to your application. Every request will take 10 seconds to process it. Too much workload on your application server, which will degrade your application performance. High chances that it may bring down your system if it gets too many concurrent requests. So how can we improve this situation? Is there any solution? This is where asynchronous process will help. Now let's understand what is asynchronous process. How does it differ from synchronous process? In simple words, you went to a shop, gave your list of items you want to order. You didn't wait there till the order is ready. You just returned back from the shop and focusing on your other work. Once order is ready, the shop owner will notify you either through messaging or by making a call to your mobile. Then you will go back to the shop and pick your order. Here, you really didn't wait in the shop till you get your order. Now, let's apply the same logic on the application too. You made a call on this application. Now, this application validates your input, stores it into the database, sends an acknowledgement then and there, immediately. Within 2 seconds, you will get back your acknowledgement. In the background, a process will pick up open requests from the database. It will make a request with order processing service. On successful processing with order processing service, it notifies the user in different ways of notification. It can be email, a message, in any other means. So here, the previous case, the user got acknowledgement after 10 seconds, but in this case, user got acknowledgement in 2 seconds, which is a great significant improvement in the form of response times. This is called asynchronous processing. You might have implemented callback mechanisms in your application while making an Ajax call, which is a perfect example of asynchronous processing. Now, let's discuss how to implement asynchronous processing in an application. In this application, these bunch of servers are accepting requests from users, storing them into database, responding them back immediately. An asynchronous job, which is running as independent service, reads all open requests from the database, start processing them one by one sequentially. This is one way of processing pending requests asynchronously. this will be a best fit if it is a small-scale application. The drawback in this approach is, as more and more requests are adding up, since there is only one async processing node, it takes too long to process all pending requests and too much workload on this node. There could be chances that async processing job node can break. Does adding more async job nodes will help here? Let's check. In this case, we have added multiples of asynchronous job nodes. They can distribute pending requests between them, but they are reading open requests from DB independently. Very high chances of processing a pending request by more than one async job. That means duplicate processing of the request. Also, there is absolutely no control on which open request will be processed by which async job processor. So here comes the message queues. Here we introduced a message queue. A queue is first in, first out. When an application server accepting any request from the user, first it writes into database and then it adds a message into queue also. The message may contain acknowledgement ID or primary key of the request. Now, this queue let the message to be read once, and after reading the message, it will delete it. In this case, only one async processing job can read the message and process the pending request. So strictly no duplicate processing and capable enough to handle large scale request without any issues on the application servers. Now, what is message queue? Message queue is a kind of asynchronous service to service communication used in microservice architecture or distributed systems. Each message will be stored in the queue until it is processed and deleted. Each message is processed only once by a single consumer. Message queue helps to decouple heavyweight processing from application servers. Message queues enables only one-way communication between two applications. Now let's compare how does it is different from making API calls. Application in general will have two-way communication with each other. When an application sends an API request, it expects the response back, which is called two-way communication. On the other hand, with message queues, the application just sends a request but never expect a response back. So that's why it is called one-way communication. Also understand that publisher and subscriber model is different from asynchronous process we are discussing here. We will have a separate video on publisher and the subscriber model. At very high level, publisher and subscriber is many to many, but message queues are many to one. Just remember this for now. We'll have more details in our next video. Don't you see a risk of single point of failure here? What if your message queue goes down? Your application will definitely fail, right? But definitely not. Message queues also supports cluster mode. In that cluster, you can form multiple queues and they will avoid risk of single point of failures. And also they address scaling at queue level. The major advantages with message queues are decoupled architecture. One application's job is to just send messages to the queue, and another application's job is just to receive messages from the queue. This separation allows for components to be operate independently while still communicating with each other. Fault tolerant. Even when the receiver application is down, the messages would still store in the queue until it comes back up and retrieve them. Scalability. We have already seen how it improves application scalability by freeing up resources on application servers. So this is about asynchronous processing using message queues in distributed systems. Hope you like the concept. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel.